Benvenuti a Master of Magic Web TV. Oggi abbiamo davvero uno dei giovani talenti americani che sta avendo grandissimo successo come consulente di David Blaine e parte di uno degli spettacoli di Broadway che hanno davvero una lunghissima durata, ed è davvero un piacere per noi avere qui Azzywind. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, sir. And whatever you said, it sounds good. I have no idea what you said.
In Italian.
I hope it's good.
Yeah, it's good. It's good.
So I have this guy here. He doesn't know anything. Okay.
But you will see the translation on the website.
Hopefully it's good. You better be good.
Yeah. Okay. And we would like to know something about you and about your magic.
Sure.
First of all, how did you start it with magic?
I think like most boys, I start with a magic kit. I was hooked on it, and I never made a decision to become a magician. I just did it, and it got me to here. I'm to this place. And I don't know. It's
no one that taught you something or
no,
a teacher?
No, I invented everything.
Yeah.
No, I'm kidding. Of course, I had books. I had attended conventions. I took like a magic course, read books, lots of books on the subject.
And how did you start with David Blaine?
Well, that goes a long time ago. We both live in New York, and it's a small community, as we know. Even worldwide, it's a small community, and especially in New York. And, you know, you've heard of some things that I do. He was interested to meet me, and we did some magic. And he said, you know, maybe we can do some magic. And he's a great guy. I consider him a friend before I consider him a colleague.
And do you think that the process to create new magic to share ideas, or it's something that you have inside of you, something in your mind, and then you create something?
Sure. Well, in my lecture notes, I wrote the opening, the preface is about the evolution of magic.
Yeah.
I believe that we are all just a part of the evolution. Somebody invented something, and then we took it and we changed it. I have not seen one trick since I was born, or since I started doing magic, that was totally original. Never. It was always based on another idea. I believe it's all, and that's why we need places like that, because we're going to inspire a kid now who's going to go home and say, maybe I can do it differently. And that will become a new thing. So I'm a big fan of, or a big believer in, the evolution of magic. And that's why I think sharing is very important.
So it means it's important to learn magic even from technology, so it means even from internet or...
Of course. I mean, the problem we have with the internet is that we have a lot of magic exposed to the wrong people. And that is a problem. Or we have a lot of magic done by amateurs that are not ready. It created a platform for everybody to be on, and some people don't deserve that platform. I mean, back in the day, you had to have an agent to work hard, and then you get booked, and then you're on TV. And now everybody can be on TV, which is YouTube. So some of it is, or actually most of it, is not good.
Yeah.
And that's the problem.
It's great. And do you prefer close-up or Great Illusion or some company
magic? I prefer good magic. There's bad magic and there's good magic. Anything else doesn't matter to me. I do close-up, I do parlor type of magic, yeah. And I do a show for 2,000 people. I don't perform with the big boxes because it didn't appeal to me. I have respect for those who do it very well. But in general, I think I love the mental magic, and I love close-up. I like good magic. Every time I see something good...
That's great. And what do you think about the competition? You know, a lot of competition... For example, FISM competition,
sure.
World Championship, and we have had the Italian Championship here in San Vincent. What do you think? It's a good idea for a young magician to go and to waiting for a judges.
Sure. I have two answers for you.
Yeah.
The first answer is, how can you judge art? How can you say this artist is better than this one? It's like going to a museum. And the only kind of work you see is Jackson Pollock. That's it, the whole in style. But what's great about a good museum is the diversity of artists. You see this kind is surreal, this one is abstract, this one is more realist, and that makes it beautiful. So when you do a competition, you'll have different kinds of performers. And it's not to say that one is better than the other. So how can you judge art? On the other hand, I think it's a good goal for young magicians to have a day that they know, I'm going to go to this convention, I'm going to do my act, and I'm going to work very hard to do it my best. So I think it's a great way to make them work. I don't care about winners.
Yeah.
I care about those who worked very hard to be the best act they can be that day. And for that reason, I think it's good. That's so.
And, there is only one chance for you to suggest a book to a young magician.
Well, obviously, it's my book, Chapter One.
No. I would like to introduce your book.
No, a little advertisement there. I will recommend three. Can I recommend three books?
Yeah, okay, it's right.
I grew up with expert car technique.
Yeah.
I love it. Some people say it's not accurate. Some of it is not wrong. But for the most part, I think there's a lot of magic in expert car technique. If you want to learn magic, you want to learn some sleights and moves and just get a diversity of knowledge about card magic, that's a great place to study. A book on showmanship, I will definitely recommend Magic and Showmanship. I think it's the best book ever written on the subject by Henning Nelms. Magic and Showmanship, is it in Italian?
No, only in English.
So first buy a book on how to learn English, and then buy Magic and Showmanship. And the third book will be actually a series of books, which called the Tarbell Course of Magic. If somebody will really take it as a challenge to study every volume, it's 8 volumes, and if somebody will study the whole thing, it will be a great magician with an amazing knowledge. So that will be my book recommendations.
Great. And so a lot of young magicians ask me, and I think even to you,
okay,
if you are stressed before the show. Are you?
Depends when you asked me. Back when I started, I was stressed, I was nervous. And today it's a little different. Today I'm trying to make myself nervous, because I think if you're nervous, there's something in your body, this
energy
that, you know, is good. Right. There's bad anxiety and there's good anxiety.
Yeah.
You know, so today I'm trying to induce it artificially, so I'm actually in the moment. But today not so much. I'm not nervous. I'm excited. Nervous was traded with excitement.
Yeah. And what's your plan for the future? So means next show or next convention?
I just had an amazing conversation with Max Maven.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you a quick story. I was doing a show maybe a week ago, and I'm sitting with a bunch of people. I did a lot of great magic for them. And then they asked me, what's your plan for the future? What do you want to do? Do you want to become this world renowned magician? I said, no, my goal is to be right here showing you magic and seeing you, because I've practiced all my life for this moment. So my goal is to be right here. And my goal right now is to be with you and talk to you about magic. So I do whatever my heart tells me to do. I don't believe in making big plans. I'm focused on the present.
It's great. So thank you very much indeed. I would like just a last question.
Sure.
I would like to ask you, what do you think about the convention on Southern Sun? And if you suggest to everyone to come here.
Okay, so it's a little longer answer in this one. And I'm saying it not because it says here, Masters of Magic. I'm really sincerely saying this. First of all, just coming to Italy, to this little town, is worth the whole trip. Beautiful, beautiful views. The air is awesome. The food is amazing. And the convention is awesome. I think this is like, I've been to many conventions, but when have you attended a convention that had Juan Tamariz, Danny De Ortiz, René Levant, Jeff McBride?
Max Maven, you said.
Max Maven, unbelievable lineup. This is very uncommon. Usually you have 2 or 3 headliners. Here it seems like every performer is a headliner. Could have been the head of any other convention. I'm pretty impressed.
And may I add to your list even As it went, thank you very much
be here. Thank you. It's my pleasure to be among this lineup.
So, ladies and gentlemen, signore e signori, grazie. Grazie di aver seguito questa intervista. Thank you very much to As It Went for this interview, and I hope to see you again in Italy. Thank you very much.
Thank you.